clients within certain criteria to come and stay here on cheap holidays. They pay like 150 quid, you get them a week.
Guys, come on that one. Right. If you yourself say you wanted to come here and you wanted to stay a week in this particular apartment, it's a lovely apartment, yeah, it's one bedroom, it's nice.
Yeah.
Maybe you have to pay for your own flights and your food, etc. What would you pay for a week here?
Gosh, I don't know what the rent is.
No, roughly, if you were coming in, what would...
Well, I suppose you would think, this is maybe illogical, you would pay your maintenance fee, a maintenance fee if you were an owner. I think they charge everyone about the maintenance fee.
So why is this, like, 1 week I'm here, it's costing me about £14,000 a year to have a week. £1,000 a year.
To have a week?
Yeah. How'd you work that one out?
And it does, by the time you look over what you've done over the years, it does mount up. Absolutely.
Yeah, but it shouldn't be. Not when they promise, when they say,
I suppose.
You know, and all they're doing there is lining their own pockets.
Well, absolutely. Absolutely. It's sales team at the end of the day. The team that you've been going to see, the people that you've been seeing, are a sales team. It's exactly the same the world over. And you've got two cities, haven't you?
Yes. But that wasn't by choice.
No.
At the time. It's only because when we were told by Silverpool, either you do this or you've lost everything. You know, and it says, you know, it's your choice, but you lose everything. And that's when we got done through the 20, I think it was 23,000. You know, I mean, to me, that's why should I just pay 23,000 when I've already paid out 60,000, 70,000 anyway?
I don't understand that, because like you said, there's other clients that are here, when you've got your membership certificate, that is yours. Anyway, you know, even if you...
Precisely. I mean, let's come to the end of this year, I'm going to be paying maintenance on two places, which is more than I should be paying for stopping somewhere for a week. Why am I paying back to that?
Not too bad.
Really?
Not too bad, really.
It's about £500, £600?
£190.
No, that's each.
Yes.
So that's £800.
Yeah.
I can go anywhere. Yeah. I can go anywhere for £800 and stop somewhere for a week.
You can go anywhere,
can't you? Yeah, but I mean,
that's okay.
Yeah. You can go anywhere for that. So I'm paying all this money, all these loans, every year I'm paying a maintenance for something that I can't got anyway. And for someone to just take money away from me like that. Yeah. I ain't happy.
No.
Oh, yeah, I'll admit it. I'm not going to say, you know, yeah, well, yeah, things will get better.
They won't get better.
Tell you now.
Well, of course it won't. I mean, you've got that, like you say, you've made certain plans to do things, you know, you've made them to, you know.
Yeah, what am I going to get from these sales? I'm going to get nothing.
Okay, then you need to wait until the resales department opens in 2015. I can give you a letter to say that it's going to open. You know, we're guaranteeing that.
Yeah, in the meantime, I'm still paying out all this money, so I'm never going to, not this way. You know, it's just
ridiculous.
Out of this situation, I don't want to have this all this money that's on top of me, you know. Which I'm paying.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
Yeah.
Unless you wait for
resale. You know. First way, some point, they're easy to get money off you, but not very easy to get give you any back. And
they don't buy back weeks, though. You know, they are a resale company. That always has been made clear, I think. You know, they don't.
No. That's not what they say.
What do they say?
An investment. Mm-hmm. That you would get money back and you would be able to...
Which you will do, you know, you will do.
But we haven't for the past, 5-6 years.
No, indeed.
And when they've actually said, well, this is better, it's a better idea, and said, tell you what, we'll take these off you and give you this one, and they'll give us next to nothing for them.
Well, again, you know, I think, you know, we're just trying to make the differentiate between the two. One was the Dot Properties and Silverpoint. We are trying to
sort of... It's still the same company.
Oh, they're not.
Well, I think they are.
You've got some of the same people involved, yes, which is what I said to you. You know, when the sales manager for Resort Properties is now the CEO.
And that's a total, really, £97,379. That's what it's cost me over the years, from Resort to Silver Point. Now, you're not going to pay that sort of money for 1 week.
No, it's not true.
Yeah, but the only two was because when we went to... when the signers on again, oh, we'll give these two. We didn't want to. It was just what they gave us. You know what I mean?
We've had a choice to cancel that.
Oh no, if I cancelled that, then I would have lost all the other. That's what I said.
Yeah.
Well.
That is terrible.
Yeah. And other people we've spoken to that doing the same point, they've never been asked to pay any more money.
No. When you said to me on the phone, I went.
Yeah. Why was I?
Well,
I've already told. We didn't do this, we lose everything because all the database has gone. So we didn't know exactly what we've got or anything. Beforehand, as I said, from resorts.
Well, yeah, no, which we didn't. We did that at our fingertips. You know exactly what you owned as of.
Well, it's funny because it was, what's it's in charge now? What's his name? It was the.
Mark Cushman.
Yeah. He was the one that dealt with me every time.
Right.
He did one of them drills. He was the one that used to come out and write down how much, you know, you need to borrow and all that. He was the one that authorised it and checked to make sure you can get the loan.
Yeah.
So we know about all that.
Well, I mean,
and that was with resort.
It's done the same way now.
Silver Point.
It's done the same way now.
Yeah.
You know,
but I mean, he did know.
Application.
Every time, he used to come to the desk, whatever rep we was with, then he'd always come up at the end, get his pad out, and do his normal bloody scribbling bit, and saying, well, this is the amount of money, blah, blah, blah. This is what you need to get out, you know, to get out of the problem, blah, blah, blah. So he knew. Yeah. Am I going back out on that experience?
No, and I understand that, and I don't mean to be rude to you or anything else. I'm just saying to you, yeah, I think that's awful.
By selling a couple, I mean, I know, like I say, it's not selling yet, but never going to get that sort of money from selling 2 weeks. So they sold it to me for that money, but I would be able to sell it.
Right. And I'm working in sales, so I never put any costs down. I mean, it is a valuable product, you know, and they are adding value to it with everything that they're doing, you know.
There's my point earlier on.
Yeah.
I wouldn't pay £14,000 a year for this one week in here.
No, yeah.
Which is what I'm doing. Which is what I'm doing because of all that.
You don't own
it. No. Yeah. I don't think there's much more I can say there, or you can say.
No, I can't give you anything until I've gone out there and found out. You know, I don't want to pick up to do this, if you do that, we can do the other. That is going to be difficult.
Oh, of course it is, yeah.
That is going to be very difficult for me, so.
Yeah.
I mean, I can only go back to speak to them and see what
you can only say what you can say.
Yeah.
And I'm not optimistic at all, so.
Well, I ain't got anything to do, but
I am determined. I'm sure whatever it takes me to do it, I'll do it.